Hi, I'm Steve Forbert. I'm here to talk to you about the 35th anniversary re-release of Alive on Arrival and Jackrabbit Slim. Regarding the recording of that record, it seems, my memory is, it required a lot of concentration, a lot of hours work. No overdubs on that record or Jackrabbit Slim either, which means all of the music you hear recorded at the same time with the same people in the same place, the same moment. I think you can hear it in these recordings, and you can kind of hear the concentration of the various people focusing on just getting the tracks as best we could. The most often played song from the album through these years has been Going Down to Laurel, so I guess that's the most significant track. I've played What Kind of Guy a lot too, but I probably have to be Going Down to Laurel. Everybody here seems to like to laugh. Jackrabbit Slim, recorded about a year after Alive on Arrival in 1979, was a different cast of characters and recorded in Nashville with John Simon producing. Steve Berg produced Alive on Arrival. John Simon produced Jackrabbit Slim. Once again, all of the recordings took place live on the floor, no overdubs, everyone focused on the same goal at the same moment. So I think, once again, you can hear the focus of all these people right onto the same goal. But these two records got me off to a real good start. I'm glad they're being re-released. I think, obviously, the fact that Jackrabbit had the hit Romeo's Tune sort of blew things open a little bigger for me, and a lot of touring, a lot of recognition from a lot of people that weren't aware of something like Alive on Arrival, which was more of an insider's record. That's the way a hit single can be. And of course, I've listened to the radio all my life, so, you know, I was pretty happy about being on the radio with a hit single. This year, I'm going to be playing several shows, just singing all the songs in order from Alive on Arrival as a sort of anniversary concert series. And then I think that might happen with Jackrabbit Slim. This package that Blue Corn Records is putting out, sort of the fact that it's going to be in stores and properly distributed, sort of means, I think it validates these two records in a special way, and I'm proud of that. It's been a long time, and I guess you could say that it would seem that they've stood the test of a bit of time.